Hi everyone. This is an overview for Chapter 6, and this chapter focuses on criminal procedure. So in Chapter 5, of course, you looked at criminal law, but criminal procedure really focuses on how the laws are applied. So criminal law is focused on, of course, what the laws are, what do they say, how are they interpreted, but criminal procedure is all about how we carry out investigations within the parameters of the Bill of Rights and the 14th Amendment. That's largely where criminal procedural rules and laws come from. And of course, case law from the United States Supreme Court. So there are 23 individual rights that are cited in the Bill of Rights in Amendments 1 through 10. And then in the 14th Amendment, there are two very important clauses. One is, of course, the Due Process Clause, and the other is the Equal Protection Clause, both of which are very important when we think about criminal procedure. For this chapter, you're going to really focus on the Fourth Amendment's procedural laws, which come from the procedural laws which come from the Fourth Amendment. So there's a focus on this chapter in regard to search and seizure and what can law enforcement do, what can they not do. And by the way, every year there are, I would say, at least a handful, you know, four or five different cases that the Supreme Court hears in regard to civil procedure. And so there are often allegations that the police did not carry out their investigations or the arrest in the way that they should have. And so this is criminal procedure is a very fluid area of the law. There are often changes given whatever the Supreme Court might decide in any given year. And so to me, criminal procedural cases are really fascinating. And I'm a Supreme Court watcher. Every year I look at the fall term calendar, and I will have you do something in regard to the Supreme Court's fall term schedule and do some research and try to come to some conclusion in regard to what you think the court should decide. But that's for a later time, just saying. There will be, I'm sure, some criminal procedure cases. Also, arrest and how are law enforcement officers supposed to arrest people? What's the procedure? Searches, of course, which are covered by the Fourth Amendment as well. What are the limits to how searches can be done? There are plenty of exceptions. There are about six or seven exceptions. I shouldn't say plenty, but six or seven exceptions. And then, of course, the Fifth Amendment has several very important things in it, but one of them is the right against self-incrimination. And the Sixth Amendment, of course, while it has several important things as well, the right to counsel is a huge one. And the Miranda versus Arizona case in 1966 was a big event for people who were poor, people who didn't understand English very well. Finally, the court in this decision is saying, hey, it's not enough just for people to have rights. If people don't know what their rights are, then those rights are useless. And of course, there was a lot of backlash in the law enforcement community when this decision was made by the court. And I want you to think about as you go through the chapter, do you think that the criminal justice system is better for that decision or worse for that decision? Not everybody agrees, of course. There's also the exclusionary rule, which is a judicially made rule, but there are some exceptions to it as well. So I think, I hope what you're starting to see as this semester is going on is that there are very few things that are set in stone in law. That there are constantly new ways to challenge what we often think are settled rules of law or settled ways of carrying out the criminal law. But it's not really true. Just because a decision is made today for this year by the U.S. Supreme Court, that doesn't mean that it might not get changed later. And so I think it's important to know what the laws are and how they change, because while these things might not directly impact you, they may indirectly impact you, because you may know somebody who is one day going through the criminal justice system, or you already know perhaps somebody who has gone through the criminal justice system. And so knowing some information can often be helpful. You're not a lawyer yet, but maybe some of you will go to law school. And so that's it for this summary. And I'll see you next week for the summary of Chapter 7. I hope you enjoy this chapter. It's one of my favorites.